Welcome to Corner Cafe, your cup of inspiration. I am Rachel Maines.
And I am Jamie Daniel.
And Jamie, are you ready to be inspired?
Rachel, I am so inspired to be inspired today.
Oh, I love that. We have a lovely lady on the show today, Natalie Tysdal. I'm so excited to introduce her to our viewers. So let's get inspired. Let's welcome Denver 2, Channel 2 News anchor, Natalie Tysdal.
Hi, guys.
Welcome.
Good to see
welcome.
You.
Good
Thanks
to see you.
Me.
I hope you're enjoying our coffee, the cup of inspiration.
I am. I take all the coffee on my schedule I can get.
Yes,
yes.
I'm sure. What time do you have to be at the studio?
Well, things are changing. For many years, we were 6 to 10 a.m., and then we moved back to 5, and now we're moving back to 4:30. So we start dark and early, we say.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Yes. What a schedule.
And what are you taking your coffee?
Oh, I definitely am milk with a little bit of coffee.
Yes. Yep. No sugar?
Oh, no, a little sugar, too.
Yes.
Yeah. It's like dessert coffee. I like it that way.
Nice.
I've never been able to drink black coffee. They don't know why.
Yeah. So you don't like the hard stuff?
No. No, I usually do a latte.
Latte, okay.
A little latte with a little vanilla, maybe.
Nice. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah.
Matches your personality.
The vanilla?
Sweet and innocent.
And a little espresso, right?
There you go.
So, Natalie, you've been in news for how many years?
Oh, gosh, do I want to say. So I started in news in college. I actually thought I was going to be an advertising public relations major, but I took a broadcasting class and I got an internship at the local TV station where I grew up in Lincoln, Nebraska, and I started as a photographer. So I was a videographer, and the cameras then were like big and massive and mostly men who were videographers back in the early 90s. And then after that, I started producing. Then I moved into reporting, and then I took an anchor role in a small town in Twin Falls, Idaho. Worked there for a few years, and then I worked in Alabama, in the deep south, in Mobile, Alabama, for 7 years. Started an NBC TV station there, was there for 7 years, did evenings. And then after my first baby, I said, I need to move to a morning shift so that I can be home, and I have 3 kids now. So the morning shift is really great as a mom, because it gives me, even though I'm a tired mom, it gives me time in the afternoon to be a mom, to be with the kids.
Awesome.
Yeah, your schedule's open for that, which is great. That's great. And what do you find right now in your role? I would say you're the most funny newscast there is out there, which people need in the morning. We need to kind of like get our coffee going, and well, for me it's tea, but get our coffee going and really laugh, and that kind of wakes us up. So what? How would you say like the dynamic is with you and Ernie and the crew? What's the dynamic
well,
there?
Well, chemistry on a show, as you all know, is so important.
Absolutely.
And I'm truly blessed and thankful that I work with wonderful people. Mm. I don't think I'd be able to do it if I didn't love the people that I work with, especially early in the morning.
Yes.
Like we're at our worst when we roll in there in the morning, so you really have to care for the people that you work with. So it's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I think morning TV has changed a lot. It's become very important to TV stations and very important in people's lives.
Yes.
Because it's a part of their routine.
Right.
So a lot of people wake up in the morning, they turn on the TV, they brush their teeth, and it's just a part of the routine, more so than evening television is often these days.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So our show being 4.5 hours long now, it just kind of becomes part of my routine. That has to be mixed with the news and the fun and the weather and the traffic, and it's just kind of all one big pot of fun in the morning, I guess you could say.
Cup of inspiration.
There you go.
Yeah.
Pot of inspiration.
A great big pot
that
we stir all morning long. Yeah, so it is a lot of fun.
Now, also, Natalie, there is a tie with you with Nebraska. Tell us what
there
that is.
There is. Mm-hmm. Well, I grew up in Nebraska. I grew up in Lincoln. I went to school there, and I went to college there, the journalism school. And that's where I got my first job. My family is still there. So Colorado is a nice place to be because we're close enough to drive home and see family. It's perfect where we are.
Nice. Very nice.
And you are a mom. You really enjoy being a mom and being a wife. How do you instill within your kids, you know, you are an inspiring person. You have a lot of energy, very sweet and very joyful. And I remember working with you in news. When you would enter the room, it was just kind of like you lit up the room, you know, because there was that energy.
I thought you lit up the room.
Oh, well, that's super sweet.
It's a very good combination.
It's the Lord in us.
You know what? That is a really good point. And Rachel and I worked together at Channel 2. What was it? I don't know. five, 10 years ago?
Yes, at least.
Yeah. And what was your question?
With your kids, how do you instill that as a mom in your kids?
Well, it's a difficult job. Yeah. My children are, one's not even a child, she's about to turn 18. So 17 is my oldest, she's in high school. And then I have a 13-year-old in middle school, and then I have an 8-year-old who's in second grade. Oof. So the kids are at all different stages. Just as mm-hmm. I master one stage, they move on to another one. So, you know, high school is not easy in any shape or form.
Right.
And she's a competitive, committed college athlete, so she has a lot of pressure there. She's
right.
probably the one calling me right now. and then my middle schooler, it's just middle school. Everything is in flux in middle school.
Yeah.
I mean, those are crucial years to really infuse our kids with inspiration, with Jesus, with
right. yeah.
morals, with these things that, you know, they're going through so much change in their bodies and their minds and at those middle school years.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And then my 8-year-old is just a sweetheart little boy. I have two girls and then a little boy who is just a handful. You know, he's an 8-year-old boy.
Boys typically are.
Just like JV.
Yes.
We all are, I admit
that. You're still
that.
An 8-year-old boy. but you know, my number one goal, my number one job is to be a mom.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I love my work, and that comes into play, obviously, but that's my number one role, is to guide them, shepherd them,
right.
the way that God has put me here, and I feel so fortunate to have been given these three amazing little people.
Mm.
I say every morning, and I actually get emotional about it, every morning when I'm walking down the stairs, and I don't open the girls' room doors anymore at night because I'll wake them up, but I kiss my son, and then I look in on the girls very quickly, and I go down the stairs, and every morning I say, Lord, just bless them and protect them spiritually,
yeah.
emotionally, and physically
wow.
in every way. And that is my 3 a.m. prayer mm-hmm. as I'm walking down the stairs with them. So that's my number one job.
Mm-hmm.
And then news. And then I have an amazing husband who is just as busy as I am. So balancing all of those things and keeping all of the balls in the air is the challenge that we face.
Yeah, and just the Lord helps us with all of that. So that is great.
Well, Natalie, you truly are an inspiration. And if people want to get in touch with you, how would they do that?
Oh, through social media. It's easy these days, right?
Yeah.
If you just Google, I have a Facebook page, a Twitter page. Everything's at Natalie Tysdal. No E on the end, just Natalie Tysdal. And Instagram. And I'm pretty active on there. It's
awesome.
A fun way to stay in touch
well,
with
we're
people.
Certainly going to be friends, all of
yeah,
us.
Yeah. Yes.
Look forward to it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Natalie.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you guys.
Good to see
truly
you.
An inspiration. Thank
yes.
you.
We'll have more inspiration for you coming up. Welcome back to Corner Cafe, your cup of inspiration.
I have truly been inspired today, Rachel.
Me too. It's nice to see inspiration in action.
Absolutely. And speaking of in action, we have our own Kirk M. Samuels on the street. Let's go there now.
I am Kirk M. Samuels, the intimacy incubator here for Corner Cafe. And I am just floored, delighted, elated to be here in this moment right now with one of my guys. This is one of my guys. I'm talking my man, 150 grand, my main rapper scrapper. This guy that I've known for almost 20 years, and his name is Kyle Speller. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing just great. How about you?
Man, best day ever, man. Best day ever. If I was any better, I'd be twins. If I was any better than that, I'd be you. Man, I'm just excited to be here in this moment with you, man. You've been a good friend of mine. I mean, you're the MC at my book launch. I mean, you've invested in me tremendously over the years, man. And so, and just as I've gotten to know you, you're a man, you're a husband, you're a father, you're a coach, you're a pastor, you're, I mean, man, if I had a whole list of everything you do, it'd be as long as my arm, man. You just invested like that in our community, just as a guy, just as a good man. And oh, by the way, you happen to have this other superhero side of you where you speak to 20,000 people at one time.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
What does that look like when you do that?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, yeah! That's right. I'm Kyle Speller. I'm the public address announcer of your Denver Nuggets, and this is going to be my 14th season. Man, I can't believe it. But we are excited about this season. You guys just wait.
Man, that's phenomenal. You're also the team chaplain.
That's right. This is my 12th season as the team chaplain.
What don't you do, man? You fill the basketballs up with air? I mean, what do you do popcorn? What I mean,
no.
What else do you do, man? I mean, that is phenomenal, man. And so just, again, I got tremendous respect for you. And I wanted to get your perspective on just some things in our culture today, specifically around masculinity and manhood as we see in our culture. And I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I feel like we kind of have a lack of heroes in our culture in terms of masculinity. Do you notice the same thing in terms of just what it's like being a guy today and just the healthy masculine presence in our culture?
One of the things that I've been seeing, and I kind of have been seeing it, it's almost like systematically being done, is that there's been an emasculation of men going on right now in our society. And with everything that's happening in the news and in the media, and you're seeing it over and over, the one thing that I really want to pour into guys is to what we call man up, and not man up just with the stereotypical type of version of man up, but man up as far as being the spiritual heads of our households, being fathers to our children, and husbands to our wives, and leading in that capacity, and stepping up and taking on leadership roles in all of our areas of influence within our reach.
And so, as a man amongst men, as a man that coaches and leads men, how do you direct men in that journey towards healthy masculinity?
One of the things that I pour into these guys is, it's the same thing I pour into my sons as well, is I call it we fight. And what I mean by that is no matter what the circumstances are, we don't lay down, we continue to fight. We continue to fight to move forward, fight to move our families forward, fight in the classroom, fight to continue to better ourselves, or whatever it is, to stay in the fight. There's a lot of pressure on men to throw in a towel, and you see a lot of that take place a lot of times, and it's easy to do so, but we want to encourage men to stay in there no matter what, no matter how many times you get knocked down, to continue to get back up and finish the fight no matter what.
Wow. So basically, don't quit.
Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't grow weary in well doing, for in due season you'll reap if you faint not.
Man, if I had a biscuit, I would sop that up, man. That's some good stuff right there, man. That's some good stuff. I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you as a friend of mine. I appreciate you as a mentor, just as a leader, and everything that you do, man. I appreciate your time here today, and I appreciate you investing in so many things that you invest in, man. I respect you tremendously.
God bless you.
And with that, again, this is Kirk M. Samuels, the Intimacy Incubator. Back to you at the Corner Cafe.
Kirk always looked like he's having a good time.
Oh my gosh, Kirk is always up to something, Rachel.
Yes, he is. Hey, we want to let our viewers know that we also do a radio program.
Yes, we do. 95.3 FM, 1220 AM, and you can stream us live around the world at cornercaferadio.com.
Let's take a look. This is absolutely wonderful. I feel...
I know what you mean, Rachel, but it's more like...
you, Jamie. I can't put it into words, but it's more like...
Hey!
Wow. You know, I couldn't have said it better.
Tune in to the Corner Cafe Radio, where we share the story and heart of an artist with Music Parade.
Man, we had a good time shooting that commercial, huh, Jamie?
Oh, Rachel, it was a great time shooting that commercial, and we have some great people to thank.
Yes, we do. We have Stacey Crawford with the set.
Curbside for delivering this wonderful furniture.
Cornerstone Construction.
Dennis Wright for this beautiful painting that you see behind us.
Tessa Fuqua with Song of a King.
Rocky Mountain CTN.
And Crawford Broadcasting. Hey, we've had a great time coming into your home and sharing some inspiration. Each week, we're going to have different guests from different industries. We have sports, entertainment, business, and the like.
And our goal every week is to inspire you to believe big things in God. So, until next time, be encouraged.
And stay inspired.